Hello guys, I'm really excited right now. I've been reading Revelation chapter 13 a lot lately. I guess God just keeps bringing it back to me. I've also been doing a lot of studying, as in how Jesus said that it would be like the last days, like the days of Noah. And I don't know if you guys know or not, but in ancient Egypt, you can see all the chimeras. If you don't know what a chimera is, it's a hybrid animal. Hybrid human being. All sorts of different things. Many of you know that when George Bush was in office, a lot of things were going down about human cloning. Human DNA research is going on. I did a little bit of stuff. I've done a lot of studying as far as CERN. As far as satanic super soldiers. I don't know if you guys have heard about the black-eyed children, but there's something going around about that. Anyway, they're actually, they're literally, they got these things. Okay, I need to read you guys chapter 13 so all this fits together, because once I read it, I know everything's going to start clicking again, so please join me and open up your Bibles to chapter 13. And we'll get this bad boy started. There's going to be several more videos after this, I've decided. I'm probably going to make a full movie out of them all. Starting with the last video I posted. Please join me and open up your Bibles to Revelation chapter 13. And what I want to touch on in Revelation chapter 13 is there were two beasts in Revelation 13. One was like a lamb and spoke like a dragon. I believe the Lord has shown me that America is a lamb-ish. A lamb-ish. Okay, when we came here to get away to our to have our own religions, our own freedoms. That's why we came here. We started the churches, everything was going really well until George Bush and all the other new presidents got into office. Okay, so what I'm saying is the lamb is America. And the king, and it speaks like a dragon now.
Should guide our public policy. Should we go with Leviticus, which suggests slavery is okay? Or we could go with Deuteronomy, which suggests stoning your child if he strays from the faith? Or should we just stick to the Sermon on the Mount, a passage that is so radical that it's doubtful that our own Defense Department would survive its application? Folks haven't been reading the Bible.
And did you not know, Senator Obama, that the book of Deuteronomy, which you also arrogantly mock and ridicule, is what gave us the Ten Commandments? Folks, all those condescending remarks distorting our Judeo-Christian Bible did not come out of the mouth of Barack Obama's pastor, Jeremiah Wright. No, they came straight out of the mouth of Barack Obama.
Okay, so I want to bring to the attention of the viewers that if you don't understand in the Old Testament in Genesis, and there's two different seeds. When the serpent seed will have enmity with the seed of the seed of men, and it's in there. It's in there. Check out Genesis 6. And that's the flood. Noah's time. And when God was talking to the serpent, he was like, your seed shall have enmity with the woman's seed. And the whole Old Testament, from that point on, just goes into about how they're warring against each other, how God's going around leading his people to the promised land and taking out all these serpent seeds. You have to understand that. You also have to understand that Jesus gives reference to human beings as trees or as vines or as bearing different kinds of fruit. You can't gather good fruit from a corrupt tree, and you know what I'm saying? I mean, the Bible is a really deep, in-depth book, guys. It's it takes more than one single glance to look over it. You need to seriously indulge yourself in the Word if you plan on understanding these end times, because these end times are seriously, they're being revealed right now. They're coming to pass right now. And I believe that the tree of knowledge of good and evil, when Satan was tempting from that place in the Bible, it specifically states that he was in or around that tree. And when Eve was seduced, beguiled. Beguiled means wholly seduced. Wholly seduced, guys. She was wholly seduced by the serpent to take of its fruit. You understand what I'm getting at? I really hope you do, because this is gonna hit some home runs, guys. God's been revealing some serious stuff to me. I've been going through a lot of stuff lately, guys. Satan knows right now that he's on my poop list right now, and I'm on his. I can tell. Trust me. you guys have no idea the persecution that I'm going through and the trials that I'm going through right now. I wish I could share some of it with you guys, but it's beyond a lot of what you guys would think would sanity would come from. That's why I'm touching on the subject of DNA. And unburied human corpses are returning to life and feeding cloning and giving image to the beast. So, for that, let's get into it. Alright, going back to Genesis 6, during the flood, God said to Noah that, basically, you found favor in my sight, and, God sent the flood because of the Nephilim. I don't know if you guys know what Nephilims are, but when God cast Satan's angels, the fallen ones, they came down on earth, and they chose, the women of the world looked beautiful to them, and they went into them, and they produced Nephilim, okay? And then those were giants in those days. Those were the men of renown. I don't believe that in this end time that is what we're dealing with, is giants. I believe that we are dealing with Nephilim. I don't know if you guys have seen Nephilim skulls or anything like this. but it really doesn't take a lot to get genetic code out of certain things. They're really holding back a lot of information at the moment, and I really do firmly believe that there are serpent seeds out here, and that they are they're doing exactly that, and they're producing. They're doing exactly that. There are they're bringing about the new world order, guys. This is what Hitler also tried to do, creating an Aryan race, a special breed of people that was better than everybody else. It's happening again. Guys, come on now. Before anybody wants to criticize me, I suggest that you do your own research, because the beauty is in the eye of the beholder, guys. All I can do is tell you what I know and what God has shown me. So the research is up to you. And it's there, because it's been given to me. I don't see why God wouldn't want you to hear about it. So I believe it's a matter of DNA, DNA insertion. And if you guys don't think that they can put different kinds of DNA inside of us without us even knowing about it, you guys need to check out Monsanto and the chemtrails, or all that type of stuff. I have no idea how they're doing it, and I probably won't. I mean, I might. I mean, I ask about it. You know, I ask God about it. I ask God about all these things, and He's showing me. So prayer is a very strong thing. I hope you guys really enjoy this and learn.
Okay, guys, for those of you who don't know about Revelation, that's when he's on the island of Patmos, and the angels are showing John certain things. We'll pick it up on verse 1.
And I stood upon the sand of the sea, and saw a beast rise up out of the sea, having 7 heads and 10 horns, and upon his horns 10 crowns, and upon his head the name of blasphemy.
Okay, so
this beast
is blaspheming God, and he's also attacking the Christians as well. Verse 2,
and the beast which I saw was like unto a leopard, and his feet were as the feet of a bear, and his mouth as the mouth of a lion, and the dragon gave him his power, and his seat, and his great authority. Okay, guys, so his mouth was as the mouth of a lion. Okay, so lions have really short, sharp teeth, and it's not something you would really want to get near. And the dragon gave him his power. Okay, we know the dragon to be Satan himself. Verse 3, guys. And I saw one of his heads as it were wounded to death, and his deadly wound was healed, and all the world wondered after the beast. Okay, so the world wondered after the beast. Why is everybody on YouTube and all over the internet looking and trying to piece together the things that are going on? And why is that? It's because it's a time of prophecy, guys. The Bible is where it's at. It's all written down for us. The world truly did wonder after the beast. We're all searching for answers. We're all looking for things that will help bring more clarity to us understanding these end times.
about verse 4. And they worshipped the dragon, which gave power unto the beast. And they worshipped the beast, saying, who is like unto the beast? Who is able to make war with him? Okay, guys. If you guys don't understand, then allow me to help enlighten you. This beast is, it's an evil thing, and it's making war. It's making war with the Christians, and it's causing people to wander after it. Okay, so I hope that clicks with you guys, because it is. I mean, it's what it says, but I mean, if you truly stop to take in every verse you read out of the Bible, it can make a huge difference for you guys. It really can, instead of just going right through it. And there was given unto him a mouth, speaking great things and blasphemies, and power was given unto him to continue 42 months. And he opened his mouth and blasphemy against God, to blaspheme his name and his tabernacle and them that dwell in heaven. Okay, if you guys don't know who the Roman Catholic Church is, basically I have a lot of information on them, and the popes have written numerous amounts of books claiming that the popes are gods on earth, and that they have changed times and dates, which is prophesied in the Bible as well. Need I say more? And it was given unto him to make war with the saints and to overcome them, and power was given him over all kindreds, tongues, and nations. Okay, so this is another big thing. The saints are going to be overcome, are being overcome, and I'm not kidding you guys. This is why I'm doing this right now, because it seems for me that this beast is truly, it doesn't necessarily have my respect, but I mean, it's a warring thing. It's definitely got the power to do many things, and definitely shake you, and it will if it hasn't yet. 8. And all that dwell upon the face of the earth, and all that dwell upon the earth shall worship him, whose names are not written in the book of life, slain from the foundation of the world. Guys, if you have not accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, do it now. Because there's things that are going on in my life and many other lives around the world right now, whom I've been studying and I'm listening to, and these things are happening not only to me, but to them as well. So I know that I'm not alone. God has placed that in my life. Glory to the Lord Jesus Christ. If any man have an ear, let him hear. He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. He that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword. Here is the patience and the faith of the saints. Okay, guys, so I want to touch on that captivity. If you're one of those people who are running around preaching, oh, we need to keep the law, we need to keep the law, Jesus Christ fulfilled the law. He became sin for us so that we would have grace and mercy through his name, so that he would be our Savior. I really hope that makes sense to you guys. if it doesn't, I pray the Lord Jesus will show you the way. Because there's a lot of ones, there's a lot of preachers out here that are going to be going into captivity, talking about how you get to heaven by good works and doing basically the law itself. When Jesus Christ fulfilled the law. And Jesus Christ specifically said that you need to put God before everything else and love your neighbor. And how do you do that? You do this by following God's will. And if you have the Spirit of God, and if you have His Holy Spirit, He leads you into His likeness. And if you pray to Him and you talk to Him and you read His Word, that's really your assurance right there, if you needed any. And we're going to continue on. And I beheld another beast coming up out of the earth. He had two horns like a lamb, and he spake as a dragon. And he exerciseth all the power of the first beast before him, and causeth the earth and them which dwell therein to worship the first beast, whose deadly wound was healed. Okay, so I firmly believe that this is the Americas. Because when the pilgrims first came here, we came as Christians to help set up our own churches over here, because we didn't like the way things were going over all the way across the world. And we were truly doing great things. We still are doing very many great things by the glory of God and His grace and mercy. And he ended up speaking like a dragon, guys. The Americas ended up speaking like a dragon. All you really have to do is listen to some of Obama's messages and some of his things that he said during his campaign, and look at things that haven't been fulfilled and how much worse it's gotten, and how he has said that we're not a country for God anymore. And there's really a lot of stuff out there, guys. If you seek the truth, it'll set you free. Okay? It'll make you free. It doesn't even need to set you free. It'll make you free. John 8:31-32. Go check that out. Continue in His Word if you want to be His disciple, to be disciplined. Okay. And He causeth the earth and them which dwell therein to worship the first beast. So that first beast, what would that first beast be? That first beast would be the one, the Roman Catholic Church. Well, the Roman Catholics and their whole thing. And, I want you guys to understand that when Hitler did his stuff, he was told to do this through the Pope at that time, and he did. So there's just a really big example of why this two-horned lamb and it spake like a dragon, causing them to worship the first beast. Basically, it's all Satan. It's all Satan. It's all trying to get the same thing to work. That's what it's putting together there for you. And he doth great wonders, so that he maketh fire to come down from heaven on the earth in the sight of men. I don't know if you guys have looking at the UFO stuff, but there's a lot more out there than there was a few years ago. And some of them look pretty interesting, guys. But for those of you who do know that they're not UFOs and that they are, there's celestial and there's terrestrial, guys. Okay, hope you're reading your Bibles. Let's continue on. And he deceiveth them that dwell on the earth by means of those miracles, which he had power to do in the sight of the beast, saying to them that dwell on the earth, that they should make an image to the beast, which had the wound by a sword and did live. Okay. So, you're saying to them that dwell on the earth that they should make an image to the beast. Okay, guys, this is the image of the beast. This is what I'm pretty sure, what I'm pretty confident in, is this is the mark. And, this is what I wanted to touch on about as far as the human DNA, the cloning. And, how that it's going to be like the days of Noah. And, I believe that, the men on Earth have figured out a way to implant us humans with a DNA parasite that corrupts us and turns us into the image of the beast. And, as I explained before on my video before this one, I believe that is what was happening to me. But me knowing the Word of God and me having Jesus Christ as my Savior, that Word of God with the two-edged sword cut that stuff out instantly, and it said, you don't belong here. This is my head. This is my seal. I put my seal in this one. Okay, so that's basically what I wanted to touch on as far as Revelation 13 goes, but we might as well just finish it. And he had the power to give life to the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as would not worship the beast should be killed. Okay, so we're going to continue on because this goes right in with 16. And he causes all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their forehead. Okay, guys, in their forehead. This beast is has now has life. And he's able to give, he has power to give life into the image of the beast. Basically, everything that I just explained to you as far as how it would, there's a parasitic DNA that's changing our normal humanity into this image of a beast. That way we have life. That way they have life. Okay, I hope you guys are following me and not just thinking this is crazy stuff, because the Lord has put this together for you. And he causes all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their forehead. I explained to you guys that there were DNA things that are going around being parasitic, and they're trying to get into people's heads. Okay, they're trying to, he's trying to exalt himself above God. And he will, if he has to, he will talk to you and try to get you to do his things. And if you accept that, then you have received the mark. Okay? You understand what that means? It means that you do, that you obediently go along with what Satan is telling you to do by listening to him through your head and performing his works with the right hand or with your hand. And that no man might buy or sell save that he had the mark or name of the beast, or the number of his name. The number of his name. Here is wisdom. Let him that hath understanding count the number of the beast, for it is the number of a man, and his number is 666. Okay, guys, so I've done some research on this as well, which leads back to the popes of Rome. All the popes of Rome. Every single pope of Rome. The Roman, Latin language is, I'm going to lay it all out for you guys. I'll tell you what, I'm going to lay it all out for you guys. I'm going to get the information and I'm just going to put it on here. And have you guys go through that as well. time, so that you will understand it, that the image of the first beast is the Vatican, Rome, and all this and that. I really hope you guys learned something from this, because it's really important right now, because this is exactly where I believe we are right now. God bless.
Okay, so
what you guys need to understand is this is not something that we can fight against. This is not something that we can fight against. This is something that is supposed to overcome the saints, okay? What we do now is let the saints know that it's known about what is going on as far as the satanic super soldiers and the New World Order happening, and the genetic parasites that are corrupting humanity and turning it to the image of the beast. You guys really need to understand Revelation 13 so badly, guys. I mean, put it all together. The image of the beast, guys. When I say the folks of the beast, that's the image of the beast, okay? That's the image of the beast. The image of the beast is to blaspheme God and not be on his side whatsoever. And that's what this DNA parasite will do, okay? That's what this fruit is doing, okay? That's what this fruit is doing. That's what this fruit is doing. Satan's fruit has been modified by the man of earth through his knowledge to make them become like gods. Oh, do you understand what I'm saying? What I really want to get through to you guys is this is not something we've war against. This is our Savior's battle. This is our ministering spirits' battle. Our ministering angels. Know ye not that you have ministering spirits? But yes, God gives us things to help deal with these things. He gives us weapons. God will reveal to you these weapons that he's revealed to me, many weapons that I can use if you read his Bible. He's given us ministering spirits that we can use to help us to our advantage. You gotta understand, guys, just because you can't see something working doesn't mean it's not. Oh boy, I'm so serious right now. A lot more than these bloody eyes can see, right? Frequencies, guys, just because we don't hear certain things doesn't mean that things don't vibrate. Do you understand what I'm saying? Like, say you got a Charlie horse. That's a vibration. It's a vibration in your leg that is hurting you. But you didn't necessarily hear it, did you? See, there's frequencies in this world, guys. This is a war. This is a spiritual war, guys. You need to understand that this is not something that you can go out and be like fighting against. This is prophecy being fulfilled. This is all supposed to happen. Glory be to God, guys. With that, I'll leave you guys with some awesome news.
iniquity. Said it's the misery of iniquity. Said it's the history of iniquity. When it all falls down, yeah. Telling you all, it all falls down, yeah. Children, eat your bread, little children, yeah. Eat your bread, cause it all falls down, yeah. Telling you all, it all falls down. Yo, y'all can't handle the truth in a courtroom of lies. Purges the jurors, witnesses, spies. Crooked lawyers, false indictments publicized. It's entertainment, the arraignments, the subpoenas. High profile gladiators in bloodthirsty arenas. Enter the dragon, black robe, crooked balance. Souls bought and sold and paroled for 30 talents. Court reporter, catch the circus on the paper. File it in the system, not acknowledged by the maker. Swearing by the Bible, blatantly blasphemous. Publicly perpetrating that in God we trust. Cross-examined by a master manipulator. The faster, intimidator, receiving the judge's favor. Deceiving sabers, doing injury to their neighbors. For status, gratis, apparatus, and legal waivers. See the bailiff, representing security. Holding the word of God, soliciting perjury. The prosecution, political prostitution. The more money you pay, the further away solution. Legal actors, Babylon's benefactors. Masquerading as the agency for the clients. Hypocritical giants, morally non-compliant, orally armed to do bodily harm, polluted, recruited, and suited judicial charm, and the defense isn't making any sense, faking the confidence of escaping the consequence, that a defendant is dependent on the system, totally void of judgment, purposely made to twist them, emotional victim, blackmailed by the henchmen, framed by intentions, inventions whereby they lynch men. Into the false witness, slandering the accused, planting the seed, openly showing he's being used to discredit, edit, headed for the alleged, smearing the individual, fearing the unsuspected, expert witness, the paid authority, made a priority to deceive the majority of disinterested peers, dodging duty for years, hating the process, waiting to return to their careers. Do we expect a system made for the elect to possibly judge correct, properly serve and protect? Materially corrupt, spiritually amok, oblivious to the cause, prosperously bankrupt, blind leading the blind, guilty never defined, filthy as swine, a generation pure in its own mind. Legal extortion, blown out of proportion, in vain deceit, the truth is obsolete. Only two positions, victimizer or victim. Both end up in destruction, trusting this crooked system. Mafia with diplomas, keeping us in a coma, trying to own a piece of the American corona. The revolving door, insanity every floor. Skyscraping, paper chasing, what are we working for? Empty traditions, reaching social position, teaching ambition to support the family superstition. When the son of perdition is commander in chief, the standard is thief. Brethren, can we candidly speak? Woe to the men, trusting in the chariots, them leaning on horses, they run their intellectual sources. Counterfeit wisdom, creating the illusion of freedom, confusion consumes them. Every word they speak, it interprets them. Outwardly white, internally they absent the light, and trapped in the night, and bondage to the cane of the night. Under the curse, evil men waxing more worse, facts of the first. Angelic being cast to the earth, it's time for rebirth. Burning up the branch and the root, the empty pursuits of every tree bearing the wrong fruit. Turn and be healed, let him who stole no longer steal. Oh Israel, surrender for Jehovah is real. How long will you sleep? Troubled by the thoughts that you keep, the idols you heap, causing the destruction you reap. Judgment is come, find it and return to the one. Abandon the flesh, self-interest, broadway to death, pride and the greed, hiding, subdividing the seed. The knowledge of good and evil is what caused us to lie, caused us to die. Let your emotions be crucified, renounce all your thoughts. Repent and let your mind be retaught. You find what you sought was based on a deception you bought, a perception of naught where the majority remains caught. Loving a lie, not realizing an atom all die. Loving a lie, not realizing an atom all die. Loving a lie, not realizing an atom all die. Loving a lie, not realizing and Adam all died. It's the mystery of iniquity. That is the history.